What's up, traders? It's Wayne from Trading Tech. Converting your trading idea into an algorithm is the first step towards automating your trading. In this video, I'll show you how to use AlgoWizard to program your first strategy. It's fast, it's free, and best of all, you don't have to type a single line of code. Let's begin. An algorithm is a program that converts an input into an output using a specific set of rules. In a trading context, the input will be live prices or a backtest data feed. Trading rules usually take the form of if-then statements. For example, if prices exceed the 30-day high, then buy one lot. Output is usually in the form of trade management. For example, you can decide to take no action or to enter or exit the market. Let's use the Bollinger Bands to build a simple trend-following strategy for the pound-yen. The idea is to jump on board the explosive trends that sometimes occur during the London session. Let's talk about if conditions. A breakout will be indicated by prices closing above the upper Bollinger Band. So our first if condition will address that. To exploit the high trading volumes, I will only enter the market during the London session. So the second if condition evaluates the trading time. My broker uses the Eastern European time zone, so the 10 to 1800 hours here roughly correspond to the London business hours. If both entry conditions are met, I will go long with a market order and place a stop loss at 50 pips and a profit target at 10 times the average true range. Lastly, I will close all trades 1 hour before the Friday close to avoid weekend gap risk. The strategy logic is symmetrical on the short side. This is an example of a successful long trade. The Bollinger Band breakout has already occurred for a few bars, but I only enter the market on this bar, which opens at 10 a.m. The 50 pip stop loss is here, and if I zoom out a little, we can see the profit target. The market pullbacks, but eventually rallies to hit the profit target a few hours before the weekend. It's time to convert our trading idea into an algorithm, so let's head over to AlgoWizard.io. Here you can have a look at the three different plans. The free plan comes with a few limitations that I will discuss later, but for now, let's just sign up for the free plan. Once you have logged in, you will arrive at this home screen. You can check out the example strategies like the EMA crossover or the inside bar breakout. But since we're going to be using the Bollinger Bands, let's click on Build My First Strategy. You will first have to choose between the simple wizard and the full wizard. The simple wizard will suffice for most strategies. But if you want to use, for example, nested entry conditions or trade management features like trailing stops or moving your stop loss to break even, the full wizard will be more appropriate. Here is where we will input our entry conditions discussed earlier. And right below that is where we will specify our exit conditions in the form of the stop loss and the profit target. Here you can see that I have checked short is symmetric to long. This means that after entering our long conditions, AlgoWizard will automatically program the reverse condition for shorts, so you don't have to input conditions twice. We'll see this in action later. At the top right, you can specify your strategy's money management. You can choose from popular options like fixed lots or fixed fractional. Trading options is where you input things like your time filters or your maximum trades per day. Variables will come in handy if you want to do parameter optimization. I will explain these in more detail when we get to them. Finally, we have the automatic quick backtest function. AlgoWizard will automatically run a fresh backtest every time you make a change to your strategy. I think this is only relevant when your strategy is mostly complete and you are just fine-tuning it. My personal preference is to turn it off. Alright, so let's get started. First, we'll add a few important variables, so open up the variable window. These four entry and exit signals are not relevant for this strategy, so we can ignore them. For the Bollinger Bands, we will need a lookback period, so let's add a new variable. Keep the type as integer, and set the value to 50. I will check this config option here because I want this variable to appear in the input window when I attach the program to a chart in MT4. If you want to optimize the variable in future, you should check this. We will do the same for the stop loss. This time select double for its type because it's possible to use decimals. Repeat this for the ATR multiple, which we will set to 10. Let's add our first entry condition. Let's search for BB. A long list of signals will appear. Signals are predefined trading conditions which are commonly used, so you don't have to manually specify each part of the condition. Select BB closes above upper band. Chart refers to the market and time frame we want to apply the condition to. We are using the current market and time frame, so we can ignore this. For the period, select the variable we assigned earlier. The deviation is the standard deviation multiple used for the upper and lower bands, which is 2 by default. It generally works pretty well, so I won't change it. Computed from refers to the price type used to compute the Bollinger Bands. Closing prices are used by default, so we can leave it. Lastly, the shift refers to the specific bar that the condition is applied to. A shift of 1 refers to the most recently completed bar, while 2 refers to the bar before that, and so on. Now let's set up our exit conditions. Toggle the stop loss. We want a fixed 50 pip stop loss, but we need to assign the variable we created earlier. So click on the input field, click on the three dots, and select the variable. We'll do the same for the profit target, but this time we'll select ATR based. Select the variable for the ATR multiple, and if you want, you can change the ATR lookback period to the default value of 14. That's it for entry and exit conditions. If you look at the sell short section, you can see that the entry and exit rules for the long side have been automatically reversed because I have the symmetry option checked. Let's talk about money management now. By default, the strategy will open a fixed 0.1 lots for every trade. Let's use fixed fractional money management instead. So select risk fixed percent of account. Risk in percent is the percent of your account that you will risk per trade. Let's be conservative and use 1%. Size decimals addresses the number of decimal places used for your order size. It depends on your market. For example, if you are trading Forex with micro lots where the lot increment is 0.01, enter 2. If you trade futures, enter 0. The stop loss in pips field is not relevant since we specified a 50 pip stop loss earlier. Size if no money management serves as a failsafe in case your lot size cannot be computed for whatever reason. Use a small value like 0.1 lots here. Lastly, maximum lots places a cap on your lot size as your account grows. Trading options is where you can input time-based entry and exit filters for your strategy. For the Friday exit 1 hour before the close, toggle exit on Friday and key in 2300 hours. Don't forget to use your broker's time. For the intraday time filter for the entry, toggle limit time range and key in 10 to 1800 hours, which corresponds to the London business hours. Before running our backtest, we need to specify its settings. Select your time frame and market, which in this case is the 1 hour pound yen in the Eastern European time zone. The free plan has some backtest limitations. Firstly, you can only backtest over the most recent 1 year period, and you can't adjust your transaction costs. The spread of 5 is pretty high for most markets. If you want to remove these restrictions, you can sign up for the AlgoWizard Pro plan. I've included a link in the description that will give you a 20% discount. With the Pro plan, here's an 11-year backtest starting from 2011. In the Overview tab, you can view your performance metrics like your profit factor and return over drawdown ratio. In the Trade Analysis tab, you can find areas for improvement. For example, in this P&L by weekday window, we can see that the strategy usually performs better when trades are opened earlier in the week. This is not surprising, because we have a Friday close, and trend following trades usually need some time to develop. So based on this result, you could, for example, prevent entering the market on Friday. If you prefer to use MT4's backtest engine instead, you can head over to the source code tab where you can select the export format. You can export for MT4, MT5, TradeStation, or MultiCharts. Save the MQ4 file and import it to your MT4 platform. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. Be sure to like and subscribe so you don't miss any trading tips. Check out the link in the description to get your discount for the AlgoWizard Pro plan. Till next time, trade well and take it easy.